Hi, I'm Susan Roberti, and Aaron and I are on the road, and we are having such a good time. Welcome to Let's Talk Tailwaggers. Like I just said, we're at the cat show since 1906. And if you ever see any kitty cat shows or dog shows, but cat shows are very quiet and relaxing and nice. And I think you would like it. I really do. Please remember that BPTV is all volunteers, and you are more than welcome to come up and do a show, like a cat show. If you have a car, if you play guitar, anything, come up to the station. It's lots of fun. And we need camera people like Aaron. It's thank you, camera person. That brings me to these shows. It's wonderful. BPTV is a wonderful little corner of the world. So now we are going to walk around and see all these elegantly beautiful kitties. There's no word. You do know that there's a God, right, Aaron? When you see all these kitties. So we're off, and next you'll be seeing a jewel.
Not a breeder. Oh, I'm just an exhibitor.
Yeah, you just enjoy them.
I just enjoy doing it.
Does he like it?
Oh yeah. He has fun with the judge.
Oh, and how many times does he win? All the time?
Well, he's going for a national. So he's up there.
Oh my Lord.
But he does like it. Loves playing with the judges. They're kind of dog-like. They follow you around the house.
Yeah, they do. I know. I have two.
They're active.
Yeah. Look at the size of the feet.
He got the little black pads.
Oh. Look up here so everybody can see how pretty you are. Can you be pretty? No.
What?
No.
Says, oh, I've been sleepy. We didn't get much sleep last night.
Look at the eyes. Oh, my God. And your face. Now, he's the only kitty you have?
No, I have two others at home. I have two others at home.
I was going to say. And are they the same?
No, they're Burmans.
Oh, Burmese.
One's a seal point, one's a blue point.
I have Tonkinese.
Yep.
I love them. They're just, you know.
But yeah. Hi. Can you see that?
He's gorgeous.
Thank you.
We'll stay here forever. Well, hi, beautiful. He looks like the Grouch on in the can on Sesame Street. Oh, you're
nope.
You gorgeous.
His name is Trooper.
Trooper. Oh, how'd you get that name?
I was going to do something like, because his daddy was a national winner, so he was going to follow in his footsteps, and he was going to be Otto's super trooper. Aww. He was going to be trying to be a trooper to be like his daddy. And
that's that's a wonderful way.
But trooper.
Yeah.
All right, I have to get in the ring.
Yeah, I have. Are you going?
Yeah, I have to go.
Okay.
All right, well, thank
Good
you.
Good luck. Look how beautiful. Okay, we're going to watch the kitties and see if they get shed.
Well, I'm an exhibitor here. I live in Rochester, New York. A lot of us who come to the cat shows travel quite a ways to come to the shows. Actually, this isn't that far of a trip.
Really?
Although it was a little questionable Friday driving in the snow. But
Oh, my goodness. Now, how long have you been doing kitties?
Actually, I've been doing kitties all my life. My parents had registered the cattery before my brother and I were born. And we actually have the oldest cattery in the whole association that's still active.
Wow. Yeah. Yeah. Wow. And does your whole family, this kitty's a Siamese.
This is a Siamese. She's a blue point female. Her name's Olympia. And she is a year and a half old. She's currently the best Siamese in the country. We're hoping to keep that.
Ooh, really?
Although the competition from California is narrowing in on her.
Really tough.
Yeah.
Really tough. But she's gorgeous.
Yeah.
Show everybody your face and how beautiful you are.
Yeah.
Now, you enjoy this to no end, right?
I do.
Yeah, and the kitties do, too.
Yeah.
They like the attention.
Yeah.
Look at the face on this kitty. How beautiful.
She says she could take it or leave it, actually.
Yeah.
Some of them really think it's fun. She doesn't think it's that much fun.
Look at you. She's putting her head in.
Yeah.
She says, leave me be.
Yep, leave me be.
Yeah. So how many more years do you hope to do this?
A while.
Yeah. Do you drive? Does your husband come too?
No.
Do you drive yourself?
I drive myself, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, you're a trooper.
Yeah.
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 Oh, you said you're waiting.
Yeah.
What's going on?
Well, what's going on is now they've got, as they're judging them, the clerk will put up what cats are next in the ring, and she's next in the ring, so I'm going to go put her up there.
This little guy. Yeah. Oh, yeah. She's next. She's next.
Yeah. I mean, it'll be a little while before the judge gets to her.
Yeah.
But they have her cage space there,
so
I'll go put her up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank
okay,
you for talking.
This
one is precious. Oh, my Lord. Oh, how beautiful.
You can't imagine why. Look at
them,
right?
Look at the face. Just gorgeous. There you are. Name is
Charlene Celesnoff.
And how long have you been doing this, Charlene?
4 years.
Oh, and look at the smile. I think you like it, huh?
Oh, Maggie is wonderful. She's such a kind girl. She gets along with my little dog so well. They're like sisters.
What kind of baby is this?
This is a Maine Coon. It's a big female. The breeder was Linda Murphy in Cleveland. And the disposition is terrific, absolutely terrific. I recommend Maine Coons to anyone that wants a kind, gentle cat. Right?
I've never heard of a mean one. They're all sweet and kind.
Yeah, but anyway, and it's wonderful what they've done here with the show, moving it, and it's lovely.
Do you enjoy it?
Yes, I enjoy it very much, right? Do you enjoy it? I don't think so. I think she wants to be home, but...
Who cares? Look at the feet. Oh, Lord. Huh? And how many hours do you spend combing and brushing?
Every day, twice a day, at least.
Yeah.
Just to keep it up, keep her hair up. The bath is difficult. But we manage.
Yeah, I had, he just passed away a few years ago, but I had a little guy, and when I got him, I bathed him right away. When he was little tiny.
Yeah.
And he used to get in the bathtub with me. I mean, cats will like water.
Well, when I brush my little doggie's teeth, she sticks her nose in there and she gets her teeth brushed too. Yes. She just loves attention.
Look at her looking around. Yeah,
she's a good girl. Thank,
yes, she
thank
is.
You for coming here and telling
me. Hey,
all
this. I like, to get everything out. And animals are my everything. And I've been doing animal shows for 23 years. And I like to get people, they go, it's not true. Kitty cats, are magnificent.
Yes, they are. They're gorgeous.
You know,
they're
and you
companions.
And you just can't open your car door and throw them out, and you're going to survive. That's not true. You know. Oh my, it's a poor girl.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you so much. And they like to be in their cages. And kitty cats, you know, you can just have them that they will not come outside. My kitty cats, you can open the door and they just look at you like, no, thank you. And what is your name?
Alice Shep.
And what do you do here?
I'm the manager of the show.
Mm-hmm. Oh, are you?
Yeah.
Put everything together?
Yes.
How long have you been doing this?
This is our 8th show. Yeah, and this is our first time here, and it's absolutely a beautiful.
Yeah, it is. The lighting's perfect.
It is, and they're nice, nice people around here. I mean, very much cat lovers.
How could you not be a cat lover?
Well, that's,
what's this guy's name?
This is Cooper, and he's a retired show cat. 2 years ago, he was the 5th best cat in the country. Maine Coon.
Maine Coon.
Yep. And
yeah.
So I brought him.
You know, these cats are really getting popular.
Yeah, I breed.
Yeah, I mean it with all my heart. Years back, you know, you'd hear here or there, but now it just really seems like they're getting their own.
I guess. I mean, I know Marilyn is also on the show committee, and she's the one that got me started.
Oh, how long have you been doing it?
12 years.
We'd like to see the Abyssinians.
And I have another one here.
Yes, she has another one.
441. To bring six.
I know. And this is Elmo.
Elmo. Yeah. Oh, my. Hi, Elmo.
And I'm showing him.
Are you?
Yeah.
And has he won anything
yes,
yet?
Yes, he has. He's been best.
Are you a winner?
Yeah.
Are you a winner?
So far, it's only his third show, so he's,
yeah,
whoa.
Scared.
He's he doesn't like the mic. The microphone.
I think it's the noise that scares him, too.
Yeah.
Because they hear.
Yes,
all right, go on. See, I try to tell people, when you get a kitty, if you keep them in, they stay in.
Yeah.
You know, well, if you get one from the animal, humane societies or something, that's altogether different. But I have two kitties. You can open the door.
Yeah.
You can open the door.
And they won't go out. Mine don't go out.
Uh-uh.
You know, this Cooper is so gentle that I took him to Friendship Village, a retirement community, and they asked me to come, and they have the independent living, and they have a health care where the people are declining, and I've gone 3 times. They just called me again to come back, but it's really enjoying. He's so gentle.
And he loves it, I think.
I took him. I took Elmo and him and a female, and they, you know, they just love petting them, and they said, I haven't touched a kitty since I had...
That's a beautiful thing you're doing, because people don't think, when people go in to the retirement homes, they sometimes have to leave their dogs.
I know, that's what they tell me.
And a real heartbreaker.
Well, the real heartbreaker was Linda Foucault, who's the Post-Gazette Pet Tales writer. She was there for one of the events that I held there. And I got a call. She did an article, very nice article. And I got a call a week later from the Baptist home in Mount Lebanon, and they had a woman who was dying, and her last request was to pet a cat. I don't know if she didn't, you know, how do you say no? You can't say no to that. So I took Cooper, not knowing what he's gonna do, and I put him on the bed. He laid, stretched out and laid next to her and never moved for an hour and a half.
See, they know.
They know, they really know. You know,
Yeah. And when you get one, you bring it home. They're 10 years old now, but I brought, my son got them and brought them home. And I'm usually the lover. Everybody comes to mom. But boy, I woke up the first night and I looked over, and there it was up on his shoulder.
Oh.
And it opened its eyes and looked, and I said, you little stinker. And that's who he picked.
Really?
Yeah.
They do pick.
They do. They do.
This one is mine.
Yeah, and they know what's in your heart.
Yep. They know they're safe. You know, I have eight of them now. So I know.
Who does all the combing?
Me. All the feeding, all the litter. But, you know, some breeders, when they have a cat that they're a female, for example, that they're breeding, you really shouldn't breed Maine Coons past 5-6 years. They have big kittens. And she, a lot of people give them, they call it petting it out, which I hate. I mean, once they're in my house, they're in my house. So I have Cooper's mother, retired, and she's spayed. So, but I keep them. That's why I have so many.
You're a softie.
Yeah, I'm a softie.
Yeah, yeah. What do we call them? A failure?
A rescue. Yeah, I hear that all the time. Yeah.
He likes to just look out at the world, huh?
He does.
Yeah.
They're used to having the run of the house at home, and so being caged up is not their cup of tea, but
they
do okay.
Well, they feel safe in there, though. You can look at them and see that he's very, very happy, and he says, leave me alone.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm with my brother. Yeah, you really enjoy this, don't you?
I really do. You get to meet a lot of nice people. I went to Friendship Village because a lady went to our show in Monroeville and emailed me that she said, I might be 83, but I'm spry and I can get around. I'd love to help. She was here yesterday.
Aww.
And I became friends with her. I have lunch with her. And she's the one that asked them if I could come.
Because
you have to worry about their nails. With people thinners.
Yeah.
But they don't use their nails.
Yeah.
I mean, not that they never use them, but they're very good about it.
Well, that's the way they're raised, too.
Yeah.
They're just gentle guys.
They are. And I love them.
Yeah. Now, how many hours do we spend grooming?
Not a whole lot. Depends. If you're grooming for a show, it takes me 3 hours.
Mm.
They have put them in the tub, in the washing tub, in the laundry room. They get 6 different baths of different types of shampoo, because if they're not groomed to perfection, the judges won't look, they won't pick them. Even if they're a beautiful example, they have to be groomed perfectly.
Wow.
So it's 3 hours. And he lets me use a hairdryer. This one, so you have to sit there and comb and comb and comb. Yeah.
He likes the hot air.
He's not afraid of the noise. But he literally was like it was a spray.
It's
straight up in the air. It was, he's like, I'm not having this. I'm not having this.
Well, I thank you so very much for creating all this.
No, it's a group effort.
I know, but thank you, because it's wonderful that people can come and see.
Yeah.
You know, because I hear so many things over my lifetime about cats. And I tell people, they're wonderful.
Yeah.
And you just don't get one and open the car door and throw it out because it can take care of itself.
Yeah.
See, that's not true. You know, they're maybe back in the Wild West or something, I don't know. But when you get one, that's going to be a responsibility.
Yeah,
you know,
it is.
For many, many years. And they do love you.
Yes, they do.
And once in a while, they might scratch. So if you have little kids, you got to be careful until, you know, the little one gets used to a kitty. But most of the time, they don't.
These cats are very good with kids. I was surprised, because when I have kittens, the neighbors all want to come see the kittens. And I don't have any. These are my kids. I don't have any children.
Aww.
So they're not around children, and they're wonderful. I mean, kids sit on the floor, get the toys out, and they all just gravitate to them. It's cute.
What is your name?
Mark.
And what do you do here, Mark?
I clean cages, and I'm part of Troop 409, and I'm trying to get money for scout camp.
And what do you do cleaning cages? How come?
We just spray some water in there and then wipe them down with a paper towel.
Are you a kitty cat liker?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I love them, too. There's nothing better. Do you have any at home?
Yeah.
Yeah. Are they just kitty kitties or?
We have mostly cats.
Yeah. Just not special kind, though. Oh, okay. These cats are beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to steal them and take one home. They're gorgeous. Well, you have a nice day, and thank you for coming over and representing.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Have a good day. And your name is?
My name is Megan.
And how long have you been doing this, Megan?
I'm coming up on a year.
Wow, yeah. You're liking it, I bet.
I love it. Yeah. It's the best job in the world.
Yeah, is it fun to see them get home?
Absolutely.
But this is what this is.
Yeah, this is what we work.
Organization?
We're the Beaver County Humane Society.
And it really is wonderful to see them get home.
It's the best part. That's why we do this.
Oh, my God. And look how calm.
I know. They're being so good today. They just love it. They're getting unlimited scratches. It's perfect.
Oh my. So what else do we want to talk about? Is your Humane Society nice?
Oh,
do you need help? Do you need money?
We always need help, and we always need donations. We do have a donation wish list. We accept donations, and we have volunteers. We need them. We always need them.
Yeah, always need volunteers. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Dog walkers, cat cleaners.
Yeah, I think, and you know, I did a show specifically one year on people going to humane societies and walking the dogs.
Mm-hmm.
And it was always, how did you get here? Oh, well, my husband died. And so said, why don't you go down to humane society and walk the dog?
Yeah.
And it was one lady was like 11 years. And she
just never stopped walking?
No, She said, you don't know how this has fulfilled my husband
that
died.
That missing piece in life, yeah.
And she said, I stopped crying. I stopped feeling sorry for myself. She said, just taking these guys out of the cage. And they just got so excited to go for that walk.
They love it.
You know, and there's so many things that you can do at the Humane Societies to help.
Always.
Really. Yeah. Well, I'm glad. I hope you stick around a long time.
Well, thank you.
You seem like you're enjoying it.
I love it. It's the best part of my weekend.
Yeah. Thanks, baby.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thanks, guys.
Well, it's that time. I hate to say goodbye, but this kitty cat show was really beautiful. I think it was the biggest one that we've ever come to. We found some very lovely ladies to talk to and to tell us about their kitties. And as you can see, there are some people that make custom kitty trees and the Humane Societies were here. It's going to be a nice show for you to watch. You're going to see lots of colorful kitties. We stood and watched the judging this time, so you should be able to enjoy that. That'll just be a quiet moment. Kitty cat shows are very quiet and very nice. You go to the doggy shows, they're kind of up tempo. So I want to say thank you for all the lovely things that you say to me when I see you. I love you, I really do. And don't forget the Humane Societies, please. Even more now, they need towels and sheets and blankets. They need money too, but they really do appreciate when you send them the towels, the blankets, the sheets, anything that you would not give to the homeless, send to whatever Humane Society that you want, Animal Friends, it doesn't matter. Just please do that, and it'll be appreciated. So like always, I will say I love you, and I hate to say it, but goodbye, and thanks from all the tail waggers.